How to build a shelter in a post-apocalyptic world, and more importantly, why would you need it? The cities are hollow, wind whistles through skeleton skyscrapers, and the rain stings like battery acid. The power's gone, the signal's gone, and the last roof you slept under probably had teeth marks in it. But you're still breathing, which means you need a place that isn't trying to kill you. Start with junk. Doors ripped off abandoned houses, sheet metal from cars, or even billboard panels with faded ads for things that don't exist anymore. Prop them against each other. If it looks like a drunk giant built a fort, congrats, you're doing it right. Pack the cracks with dirt, trash bags, or shredded clothes. Insulation doesn't care if it used to be underwear. Need support? Trees, poles, rebar, anything stiff enough not to collapse on your skull while you sleep. If it does collapse, well, less to worry about in the morning. And for the floor, pile leaves, rags, or insulation foam, because nothing says luxury like not freezing to death on cold concrete. Here's the science. Shelter slows heat loss, blocks wind, and keeps rain from soaking your body into hypothermia pudding. It's not pretty, but biology doesn't grade for style. If it keeps you warm and breathing, it's a 5-star hotel. Congratulations, your trash palace is now a fortress. It won't stop raiders, mutants, or existential dread, but at least it keeps the acid rain off your face. No roof? No problem. Just junk, scraps, and survival.